Crews erected lighting scaffolds outside The Rock, prepping for MTV's Video Music Awards that'll storm into Newark this Monday, August 26th. The city's top cop warns it could gridlock streets like last November 15th's rush hour Snowmageddon, a traffic jam version of Dante's Ninth Circle of Hell, where the damned spend eternity frozen in ice. Public Safety Director Anthony Ambrose would like to avoid a repeat on Monday.
We're preparing like it's a full-blown snowstorm or disaster. So we'll be prepared and ready, and hopefully it'll be seamless. All eyes will be on the city because of this event. And we're going to do the best we can like we always do.
Ambrose will mobilize the Office of Emergency Management and plans to put at least 375 city cops on duty, plus federal, state, and county agents. He expects 14,000 to 15,000 ticket holders will pack the venue, and up to 7,500 more starstruck fans will crowd around for a glimpse of celebrities, all part of the spectacle.
Beyonce.
Newark police will start blocking streets on Sunday, and by 10 a.m. Monday, most rights of way around the Prudential Center will be closed to traffic until 2 a.m. Tuesday. To minimize commuter gridlock, city officials have asked major employers to let workers leave early. City Hall will close at 1 p.m. The message, get out of Dodge. Ambrose urged people attending the event to rely on NJ Transit.
This event ends at 10:45. They assured the administration that there will be extra trains and they will go later.
We expect a lot coming in from New York via path and on rail, so not as much impact on bus, but we're diverting traffic because of the setup.
NJ Transit will add just one extra train at 11:30 p.m. from Newark Penn Station to New York. It's detoured five bus routes around the event Monday and warned in a tweet, NJT customers may experience large crowds at Penn Station, New York, Secaucus Junction, and Newark Penn Station due to the Video Music Awards. Please plan accordingly and build in extra time in your travels. There is a potential for gridlock conditions in the area, but there's also potential for profit. Dinosaur Barbecue next to The Rock was packed today.
So far, so good. It's been picking up. Even our lunch right now is a lot busier than it normally is, so we're expecting a lot of money to roll in, hopefully.
The city hopes local businesses can score a few million dollars and burnish Newark's image despite a crush of crowds that could top 23,000.
We certainly do expect more spectators for this type of event, spectators that are also going to hang out and patronize the local businesses. We know that there are after parties. So we're not concerned in that regard.
Perhaps salvation awaits from NJ Transit, but sawhorses and police officers will be blocking off the main roads around this venue on Monday when the sign entering Newark may as well read, "Abandon hope, all ye who enter here, unless you get out before noon." In Newark, I'm Brenda Flanagan, NJTV News.